Hi everyone, today I'm going to give you all of my Section 2 BMAT preparation tips. With only 30 minutes to test your biology, chemistry, physics and maths, this section is notorious for its time pressure, as well as being a test of your subject knowledge. Keep listening to find out more about what the questions contain, how it's marked and my top tips. Hi everyone, my name's Jess from MedicMind and I'm a fourth year medical student at the University of Birmingham. If you'd like to learn more about the BMAT, UCAT, personal statement and all that sort of stuff, don't forget to subscribe and click the round bell so you don't miss anything. And keep watching to find out everything you could possibly want to know about Section 2 of the BMAT. So what is it? Section 2 of the BMAT is described on their website as a test to see whether candidates have the appropriate level of core scientific knowledge and the ability to apply it. So it's not just testing how much you know, but also your understanding and if you can apply it to unfamiliar problems too. The timing of the section is 27 questions in 30 minutes, so it's a lot quicker than Section 1, and this is why preparation is so important. Stick around until the end of the video and I'll give you some of my top tips. So, types of question. This section is made up of 7 questions each for biology, chemistry and physics, and there's 6 questions of maths as well. And unlike Section 1 of the paper, you are expected to have prior knowledge, with the level of that being GCSE. However, due to differences in exam boards, you might have learned slightly more or slightly less, so therefore there's a specification on the official BMAT website that lays out exactly what you need to know. There are 15 years worth of past papers on the BMAT website, so it's definitely worth having a look at these and trying to figure out which topics come up most. However, you'll want to check these against the official specification, as the topics included have changed over time. Physics tends to be the biggest hurdle for medics, as a lot of you might not have continued this to A-level, or you might have found it more difficult at GCSE. On the MedicMind website, we have revision guides that cover the topics that come up most often in BMAT physics questions, so be sure to check these out. It's also worth noting that you don't get a calculator in the BMAT, so make sure that you know your timetables, your cubes, your squares, so that you'll be a lot faster when answering those maths questions. I'll tell you a bit about how this section is marked, and then we'll move on to my tips. In Section 2, you get 1 mark for each correct answer you give, and there's no negative marking. This is then standardised to a score between 1.0 and 9.0, with 9.0 being the highest. 5.0 is usually the median score and correlates to getting about half of the questions right, and only about 10% of people get 6.0. With 27 questions in 30 minutes, Section 2 not only requires you to have a good grasp of your scientific understanding, but you also need to be able to apply it really quickly too. This is why preparation is so important to enable you to get the highest score you can. Keep listening to hear some of my top tips. And if you'd like some extra help, MedicMind's BMAT tutors can go through questions with you in much more depth. Tip number 1 is to manage your timing. On average, you'll need to do about 9 questions every 10 minutes because you've got 27 questions over 30 minutes. The answer sheet will also be split into 3 columns, so you can imagine each one as a lot of 9 questions that you have 10 minutes to complete. Bring a watch with you and you can note down the exact time you'll be hoping to finish each column of questions. Keep in mind, however, this strategy doesn't include time to check your questions at the end, so either check them as you go along or try to only take 1 minute to answer each question so that you'll have at least 3 minutes at the end to go through them again. You can prepare for this by doing as many practice papers as possible to time to make sure that you always can keep to them and you don't get overwhelmed on test day. Tip number 2 is don't be afraid to write on the question paper. In the BMAT, you won't be given any rough paper to do things like working out, so you'll need to be used to writing key information right onto the question sheet. Make sure to write down the important bits of information, but don't get carried away writing down things that are unnecessary. Tip number 3 is know when and when not to skip questions. I found that in my BMAT, as it is with a lot of other different exams, there are some questions you'll be able to answer immediately and some will take quite a bit more time. However, it can be quite easy to get bogged down by one question that you just seem unable to answer. And even when you do get an answer, you're not even sure if it's going to be right. It's not worth wasting time on questions like this. You shouldn't be afraid to skip questions that you're having difficulty answering and spending a lot of time on to make sure that you can keep to your timings. And also remember that there's no negative marking in this section of the BMAT, so any question is worth at least a guess. Beware of getting into the habit of skipping, however, as it can be very easy to skip your way to the end of the entire section, and that will only leave you more stressed and more panicked. Take the time to try and understand a question. And if you do have to skip, make a note of which questions these are so you can get back to them easily when you finish the rest of the section. Tip 4 is to use a process of elimination. Because section 2 of the BMAT is so time pressured, it's probably better to eliminate answers that you know definitely aren't correct, and this will save you a lot of time. It also means that if you're really unsure about a question, your guess is more likely to be right. Tip number 5 is to fill out your answers straight away. Once you're relatively sure an answer is, fill it out on the answer sheet immediately. Don't be that person who left it all until the end of the section and then doesn't have enough time to fill them in, even if they got everything right. My final tip is to not worry too much about the content. I know when I prepared for my BMAT that I was really preoccupied by one or two topics that were mentioned in the specification, even though they probably wouldn't come up in the paper. Have a look at our list of the topics that come up most often for each subject and make sure you know these really well. These are far more likely to come up and you'll get a lot more answers correct by learning these topics, rather than learning one thing that's really niche that might only be one question or even none at all. If you want to learn more ways to improve your BMAT, UCAT, personal statement and all that sort of stuff, don't forget to subscribe and hit the round bell so you don't miss anything. If you found this video helpful, I'd love it if you gave it a thumbs up or shared it with someone who is taking the BMAT too. If you've got any BMAT top tips, you can let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.